factoring strategy. This right here is to help you do your factoring on any type of polynomial. You want to use this list, and I think of it as a list to follow. So the first thing that we always want to do is factor the GCF. So you're always looking for a greatest common factor first. So I'm going to start a list off to the side. So one is look for GCF. And then if we have two terms, so two terms means we have two different options. One is a difference of squares. That's going to look like a squared minus b squared. And that's going to give us a plus b, a minus b. Or it could be a cubic, either with a plus in there or a minus, either one. So I'm going to write this as a cubed plus or minus b cubed. And that's going to equal a plus or minus b. A squared minus plus, because it's always going to be the opposite sign of the first one, AB plus B squared. So binomial, we're going to either have differences squares, or cubics. Three terms, it's going to be a trinomial. And basically there, we're going to do trial and error. Or if you remember the formula, you could have a perfect square trinomial. So, third, we're going to put down trinomial, and we're going to say trial and error. Four terms, that means we're going to be grouping. Four terms, grouping, and then very last, can it be factored again? Meaning, do you still have a difference of squares? Do you have a common factor inside the parentheses? That is a really good strategy, is to always look, can it be factored again? So this is lots to remember. Really recommend that you have it written down and in front of you when you're working on these. So let's go to our examples. Basically, we want to use these to decide what's going to be the best method to factor a particular polynomial. So if we look at this one, we have two terms, so that means we have either the option of difference of squares or cubic. Well, since my exponent is a 2, I'm looking at difference of squares. So if I have difference of squares, it means I put two sets of parentheses. The square root of 25x squared is going to be 5x. Square root of 16 is going to be 4, plus in one, minus in the other. I'm done. In example 2, which method would we use? Well, if I look at this, I have three terms, so that means I'm doing trial and error. It is a trinomial. So again, I'm putting two sets of parentheses down, put my x in, I don't have to worry about my factors for that. There's only one way of doing that. And then I have 20. So I'm going to use 4 and 5. And when I take my outside minus the inside, I've got 5x minus 4x, which would give me 1x. I want it to be a negative, so that means 5 is going to be negative, 4 is going to be positive. So we're going to have a negative 5, a positive 4. And I'm done factoring. Let's take a look at our last example. Which method would we use? Well, I've got 4 terms. So that means I have to use grouping. So I'm going to divide this in 2. And I notice that the first 2 have a common factor of y, so I'll pull that out. That leaves me with x plus 2. And my last 2 have a common factor of 5. So I pull that out. And that's going to leave me with x plus 2. Oh, good. These 2 are the same, so I didn't have to reorder or anything. It was just factoring it just like it is. So I pull out my common factor of x plus 2. And that's going to leave me with y plus 5. I look at it again. Nothing there can be factored again. So we are done.